The following is a free for download audiobook from the website krishnapath.org. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Part 2, Chapter 12. The Mohini Murti Incarnation Bewilders Lord Shiva. This chapter describes how Lord Shiva was bewildered upon seeing the beautiful Mohini Murti incarnation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and how he later came to his senses. When Lord Shiva heard about the pastimes performed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, in the form of an attractive woman, he mounted his bull and went to see the Lord. Accompanied by his wife, Uma, and his servants, the Bhutagana, or ghosts, he approached the lotus feet of the Lord. Lord Shiva offered obeisances to the Supreme Lord as the all-pervading Lord, the universal form, the supreme controller of creation, the supersoul, the resting place for everyone, and the completely independent cause of all causes. Thus, he offered prayers, giving truthful descriptions of the Lord. Then he expressed his desire. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is very kind to his devotees. Therefore, to fulfill the desire of his devotee, Lord Shiva, he expanded his energy and manifested himself in the form of a very beautiful and attractive woman. Upon seeing this form, even Lord Shiva was captivated. Later, by the grace of the Lord, he controlled himself. This demonstrates that by the power of the Lord's external energy, everyone is captivated by the form of woman in this material world. Again, however, by the grace of the Supreme Lord, one can overcome the influence of Maya. This was evinced by Lord Shiva, the topmost devotee of the Lord. First, he was captivated, but later, by the grace of the Lord, he restrained himself. It is declared in this connection that only a pure devotee can restrain himself from the attractive feature of Maya. Otherwise, once a living entity is trapped by the external feature of Maya, he cannot overcome it. After Lord Shiva was graced by the Supreme Lord, he circumambulated the Lord along with his wife, Bhavani, and his companions, the ghosts. Then he left for his own abode. Shukadeva Goswami concludes this chapter by describing the transcendental qualities of Uttama Shloka, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and by declaring that one can glorify the Lord by 9 kinds of devotional service, beginning with Shravanam Kirtanam. Texts 1 and 2. Shukadeva Goswami said, "The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, in the form of a woman, captivated the demons and enabled the demigods to drink the nectar. After hearing of these pastimes, Lord Shiva, who is carried by a bull, went to the place where Madhusudana, the Lord, resides. Accompanied by his wife, Uma, and surrounded by his companions, the ghosts, Lord Shiva went there to see the Lord's form as a woman." Text 3. The Supreme Personality of Godhead welcomed Lord Shiva and Uma with great respect, and after being seated comfortably, Lord Shiva duly worshipped the Lord and smilingly spoke as follows. Text 4. Lord Mahadev said, "O chief demigod among the demigods, O all-pervading Lord, Master of the universe, by your energy you are transformed into the creation. You are the root and efficient cause of everything. You are not material. Indeed, you are the supersoul or supreme living force of everything. Therefore, you are Parameshwar, the supreme controller of all controllers." Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, resides within the material world as the Sattvaguna avatar. Lord Shiva is the Tamaguna avatar, and Lord Brahma is the Rajaguna avatar, but although Lord Vishnu is among them, he is not in the same category. Lord Vishnu is Devadeva, the chief of all the demigods. Since Lord Shiva is in this material world, the energy of the Supreme Lord Vishnu includes Lord Shiva. Lord Vishnu is therefore called Jagat Vyapi, quote, the all-pervading Lord, end quote. Lord Shiva is sometimes called Maheshwar, and so people think that Lord Shiva is everything. But here, Lord Shiva addressed Lord Vishnu as Jagadish, the master of the universe. Lord Shiva is sometimes called Viveshwar, but here he addresses Lord Vishnu as Jagan Maya, indicating that even Viveshwar is under Lord Vishnu's control. Lord Vishnu is the master of the spiritual world, yet he controls the material world also, as stated in Bhagavad Gita, Maya Dakshina Prakati Suyutesha Characharam. Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva are also sometimes called Ishwara, but the supreme Ishwara is Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna. As stated in Brahma Samhita, Ishwara Parama Krishna, the supreme Lord, is Krishna, Lord Vishnu. Everything in existence works in proper order because of Lord Vishnu. Adantarasta Paramanu Chayantarastam. Even Paramanu, the small atoms, work because of Lord Vishnu's presence within them. Text 5. The manifest, the unmanifest, false ego, and the beginning, maintenance, and annihilation of this cosmic manifestation all come from you, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But because you are the Absolute Truth, the Supreme Absolute Spirit Soul, the Supreme Brahman, such changes as birth, death, and sustenance do not exist in you. Purport. According to the Vedic mantras, Yato va imani bhutani jayante, everything is an emanation from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as stated by the Lord Himself in Bhagavad Gita 7.4, Bhumir apoldano vayu, kamano buddhevacha ahankaran itiam me bini prakatyasada. Quote, earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego, all together these eight comprise my separated material energies. End quote. In other words, the ingredients of the cosmic manifestation also consist of the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This does not mean, however, that because the ingredients come from him, he is no longer complete. Purnasya purnamada purnamavashishyate. Because he is the complete whole, even though so many complete units emanate from him, he remains the complete balance. End quote. Thus the Lord is called avyaya, inexhaustible. Unless we accept the Absolute Truth as a chintya beta beta, simultaneously one and different, we cannot have a clear conception of the Absolute Truth. The Lord is the root of everything. Aham adir hi devanam. He is the original cause of all the devas or demigods. Aham sarvasya prabhava. Everything emanates from him. In all cases, nominative, objective, positive, negative, and so on, whatever we may conceive of in this entire cosmic manifestation is in fact the Supreme Lord. For him, there are no such distinctions as, quote, this is mine and this belongs to someone else, end quote, because he is everything. He is therefore called avyaya, changeless and inexhaustible. Because the Supreme Lord is avyaya, he is the Absolute Truth, the fully spiritual Supreme Brahman. Text 6. Pure devotees are great saintly persons who desire to achieve the highest goal in life and who are completely free from all material desires for sense gratification, engage constantly in the transcendental service of your lotus feet. Purport. One is in this material world when he thinks, quote, I am this body and everything with reference to my body is mine, end quote. Atogrihak chetra sutat pa Vitayar Janasya Moham Aham Ameti. This is the symptom of materialistic life. In the materialistic conception of life, one thinks, quote, this is my house, this is my land, this is my family, this is my state, end quote, and so on. But those who are Munasa, saintly persons following in the footsteps of Narada Muni, simply engage in the transcendental loving service of the Lord without any personal desire for sense gratification. Anya bilashita sunyam gamana karmani anavitam. Either in this life or in the next, the only concern of such saintly devotees is to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They are also absolute because they have no other desires. Being freed from the dualities of material desires, they are called Shreyas Kama. In other words, they are not concerned with dharma, religiosity, artha, economic development, or kama, sense gratification. Their only concern of such devotees is moksha, liberation. This moksha does not refer to becoming one with the Supreme like the Mayavadi philosophers. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained that real moksha means taking shelter of the lotus feet of the Personality of Godhead. The Lord clearly explained this fact while instructing Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya wanted to correct the word Muktipad in the Srimad Bhagavatam, but Lord Chaitanya informed him that there is no need to correct any word in Srimad Bhagavatam. He explained that Muktipad refers to the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, who offers mukti and is therefore called Mukunda. A pure devotee is not concerned with material things. He is not concerned with religiosity, economic development, or sense gratification. He is interested only in serving the lotus feet of the Lord. Text 7. My Lord, you are the Supreme Brahman, complete in everything. Being completely spiritual, you are eternal, free from the material modes of nature, and full of transcendental bliss. Indeed, for you there is no question of lamentation. Since you are the supreme cause, the cause of all causes, nothing can exist without you. Yet we are different from you in a relationship of cause and effect, for in one sense the cause and effect are different. You are the original cause of creation, manifestation, and annihilation, and you bestow benedictions upon all living entities. Everyone depends on you for the results of his activities, but you are always independent. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead says in Bhagavad Gita 9.4, Maya ittatam idam sarvam jagat vyaktimurtina matstani sarvabhutani nachaham tveshavashtita. Quote, by me, in my unmanifested form, this entire universe is pervaded. All beings are in me, but I am not in them. End quote. This explains the philosophy of simultaneous oneness and difference, known as Achintya Bheda Bheda. Everything is the Supreme Brahman, the Personality of Godhead, yet the Supreme Lord is differently situated from everything. Indeed, because the Supreme Lord is differently situated from everything material, he is the Supreme Brahman, the Supreme Cause, the Supreme Controller. Ishvara Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha. The Lord is the Supreme Cause, and his form has nothing to do with the material modes of nature. The devotee prays, quote, as your devotee is completely free from all desires, your lordship is also completely free from desires. You are fully independent. Although all living entities engage in your service, you do not depend on the service of anyone. Although this material world is created complete by you, everything depends on your sanction. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Mata Smriti Ganam Apohanam Cha, remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness come from you. Nothing can be done independently, yet you act independently of the service rendered by your servants. The living entities depend on your mercy for liberation, but when you want to give them liberation, you do not depend on anyone else. Indeed, by your causeless mercy, you can give liberation to anyone. Those who receive your mercy are called Kripasiddha. To reach the platform of perfection takes many, many lives. Bahunan janmanamante gyanamam prapalyante. Nevertheless, even without undergoing severe austerities, one can attain perfection by your mercy. Devotional service should be unmotivated and free from impediments. Ahoitiki pratiyata siyayatma supersediti. This is the position of nirashisha, or freedom from expectations for results. A pure devotee continuously offers transcendental loving service to you, but you may nonetheless offer mercy to anyone without depending on his service. Text 8. My dear Lord, your lordship is alone the cause and the effect. Therefore, although you appear to be two, you are the absolute one. There is no difference between the gold of a golden ornament and the gold in a mine, and there is no difference between cause and effect. Both of them are the same. Only because of ignorance do people concoct differences and dualities. You are free from material contamination, and since the entire cosmos is caused by you and cannot exist without you, it is an effect of your transcendental qualities. Thus, the conception that Brahman is true and the world is false cannot be maintained. Purport. Srila Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur says that the living entities are representations of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's marginal potency, whereas the various bodies accepted by the living entities are products of the material energy. Thus, the body is considered material, and the soul is considered spiritual. The origin of them both, however, is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead. As the Lord explains in Bhagavad Gita 7, 4, and 5, Bhumir apo nilo vayu kamano bidyevacha ahankariti amme bini prakriti astada apariyami tvash itas tvanyam prakritim bidi me param jiva bhutamaha baho yedam jayache jagat. Quote, earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego, all together these eight comprise my separated material energies. But beside this inferior nature, O mighty armed Arjuna, there is a superior energy of mind who consists of all living entities who are struggling with material nature and are sustaining the universe. End quote. Thus, both matter and the living entities are manifestations of the energy of the Supreme Lord. Since the energy and the energetic are not different, and since the material and marginal energies are both energies of the Supreme Energetic, the Supreme Lord, ultimately the Supreme Personality of God, it is everything. In this regard, the example may be given of gold that has not been molded and gold that has been molded into various ornaments. A gold earring and the gold in a mine are different only as cause and effect. Otherwise, they are the same. The Vedanta Sutra describes that Brahman is the cause of everything, Janmadyasya Yata. Everything is born of the Supreme Brahman, from which everything emanates as different energies. None of these energies, therefore, should be considered false. The Mayavadi's differentiation between Brahman and Maya is only due to ignorance. Srimad Viraragava Acharya, in his Bhagavad Chandra Chandrika, describes the Vaishnava philosophy as follows. The cosmic manifestation is described as sat and asat, as chit and achit. Matter is achit and the living force is chit, but their origin is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in whom there is no difference between matter and spirit. According to this conception, the cosmic manifestation consisting of both matter and spirit is not different from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Idam hi vishvam bhagavan ivetara. Quote, this cosmic manifestation is also the Supreme Personality of Godhead, although it appears different from him. End quote. In Bhagavad Gita 9.4, the Lord says, Mayam tatam idam sarvam jagat avyaktamurtina matstani sarvabhutani nachaham tveva avashita. Quote, by me, in my unmanifested form, this entire universe is pervaded. All beings are in me, but I am not in them. End quote. Thus, although someone may say that the Supreme Person is different from the cosmic manifestation, actually he is not. The Lord says, Maya tatam idam sarvam. Quote, in my impersonal feature, I am spread throughout the world. End quote. Therefore, this world is not different from him. The difference is a difference in names. For example, whether we speak of gold earrings, gold bangles, or gold necklaces, ultimately they are all gold. In a similar way, all the different manifestations of matter and spirit are ultimately one in the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ekam evad vityam brahma. This is the Vedic version, Chandrogya Upanishad 6.2.1. There is oneness because everything emanates from the Supreme Brahman. The example is already given is that there is no difference between a golden earring and the gold mind as it is. The Vaivashika philosophers, however, because of their Mayavad conception, create differences. They say, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mitya, the absolute truth is real and the cosmic manifestation is false. End quote. But why should the Jagat be considered Mitya? The Jagat is an emanation from Brahman, therefore the Jagat is also truth. Vaishnavas, therefore, do not consider the Jagat to be Mitya, rather they regard everything as reality in connection with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Anasaktasya vishayan yatarham upayanjata nirbanda krishna sambande yukta vairagimuchite prapanchita ka taya buddhya hari sambandi vastuna mukshibi paratyago vairagyam falgukartite. quote, things should be accepted for the Lord's service and not for one's personal sense gratification. If one accepts something without attachment and accepts it because it is related to Krishna, one's relationship is called Rupta Vairagyam. Whatever is favorable for the rendering of service to the Lord should be accepted and should not be rejected as a material thing. Bhaktirasamrita Sindhu 1.2, 255, and 256. The jagat should not be rejected as mitya. It is truth, and the truth is realized when everything is engaged in the service of the Lord. A flower is accepted for one's sense gratification is material, but when the same flower is offered to the Supreme Personality of Godhead by a devotee, it is spiritual. Food taken and cooked for oneself is material, but food cooked for the Supreme Lord is spiritual prasad. This is a question of realization. Actually, everything is given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and therefore everything is spiritual. But those who are not advanced in proper knowledge make distinctions because of the interactions of the three modes of material nature. In this regard, Srila Jiva Goswami says that although the sun is the only light, the sunshine, which is exhibited in seven colors, and darkness, which is the absence of sunshine, are not different from the sun, for without the existence of the sun, such differentiations cannot exist. There may be varied nomenclature because of different conditions, but they are all the sun. The pranas therefore say, Eka desha sitasyagnir jyotsna vistarini yata prasya brahmana shaktis tatedam akilam jagat. Quote, just as the illumination of a fire, which is situated in one place, is spread all over, the energies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Parabrahman, are spread all over this universe. End quote. Vishnu Purana 1.22.53. Materially, we can directly perceive the sunshine spreading itself according to the different names and activities, but ultimately the sun is one. Similarly, Sarvam Kalavidam Brahma, everything is an expansion of the Supreme Brahman. Therefore, the Supreme Lord is everything, and he is one without differentiation. There is no existence separate from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Text 9. Those who are known as the impersonalist Vedantists regard you as the impersonal Brahman. Others, known as the Mimamsaka philosophers, regard you as religion. The Shankya philosophers regard you as the transcendental person who is beyond Prakriti and Purusha, and who is the controller of even the demigods. The followers of the codes of devotional service, known as the Pancharatras, regard you as being endowed with 9 different potencies. And the Patanjala philosophers, the followers of Patanjali Muni, regard you as the supreme independent personality of Godhead who has no equal or superior. Text 10. O my Lord, I, who am considered to be the best of the demigods, and Lord Brahma and the great rishis, headed by Marichi, are born of the mode of goodness. Nonetheless, we are bewildered by your illusory energy and cannot understand what this creation is. Aside from us, what is to be said of others like the demons and human beings who are in the base modes of material nature, Rajagun and Tamagun? How will they know you? Purport. Factually speaking, even those who are situated in the material mode of goodness cannot understand the position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. What, then, is to be said of those who are situated in Rajagun and Tamagun, the base qualities of material nature? How can we even imagine the Supreme Personality of Godhead? There are so many philosophers trying to understand the absolute truth, but since they are situated in the base qualities of material nature and are addicted to so many bad habits like drinking, meat-eating, illicit sex, and gambling, how can they conceive of the Supreme Personality of Godhead? For them, it is impossible. For the present day, the Pancharatrika Vidhi, as enunciated by Narada Muni, is the only hope. Srila Rupa Goswami, therefore, has quoted the following verse from the Brahma Yamala. Shruti Smriti Puranadi Pancharatrika Vidhi Vina Aikantiki Harer Bhaktir Utpatayai Vakalpate. Quote, devotional service of the Lord that ignores the authorized Vedic literatures like the Upanishads, Puranas, and Narada Pancharatra are simply an unnecessary disturbance in society, end quote. Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1-2-101. Those who are very advanced in knowledge and are situated in the mode of goodness follow the Vedic instructions of the Shruti and Smriti and other religious scriptures, including the Pancharatriki Vidhi. Without understanding the Supreme Personality of Godhead in this way, one only creates a disturbance. In this age of Kali, so many gurus have sprung up, and because they do not refer to the Shruti Smriti Puranadi Pancharatrika Vidhi, they are creating a great disturbance in the world in regard to understanding the absolute truth. However, those who follow the Pancharatrika Vidhi under the guidance of a proper spiritual master can understand the absolute truth. It is said, Pancharatasya Kritsnasya Vakta to Bhagavan Swayam. The Pancharatra system is spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, just like Bhagavad Gita. Vasudev Sharana Vidur Ajana Ajavsaiva. The truth can be understood only by one who has taken shelter of the lotus feet of Vasudev. Bahunam Jamana Mante Gyanamam Pradyate Vasudeva Savramiti Samahatma Sadurlaba. Quote, after many births and deaths, one who is actually in knowledge surrenders unto me, knowing me to be the cause of all causes and all that is. Such a great soul is very rare, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 7:19. Only those who have surrendered to the lotus feet of Vasudeva can understand the absolute truth. Vasudeva Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Parojita Janyati Astu Vairagyam Gyanam Chayad Ahoitikam. Quote, by rendering devotional service unto the Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, one immediately acquires causeless knowledge and detachment from the world, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 1:27. Therefore, Vasudeva Bhagavan Sri Krishna personally teaches in Bhagavad Gita, Sarvadharman Pratyajah Mamikam Sharanam Vaja. Quote, abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 18:66. Bhaktimam abhijananti yavanyas chasmi tatvata. Quote, one can understand the Supreme Personality as he is only by devotional service, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 18:55. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is not properly understood even by Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma, what to speak of others, but he can be understood by the process of bhakti yoga. Mayi asakta mana prartha yogam yunjan madashraya asamsayam samangram yatmam yata yasyasi tachchenu. Bhagavad Gita 7:1. If one practices bhakti yoga by taking shelter of Vasudev Krishna, simply by hearing Vasudev speak about himself, one can understand everything about him. Indeed, one can understand him completely. Samangram. Text 11. My Lord, you are the supreme knowledge personified. You know everything about this creation and its beginning, maintenance, and annihilation, and you know all the endeavors made by the living entities by which they are either implicated in this material world or liberated from it. As the air enters the vast sky and also enters the bodies of all moving and non-moving entities, you are present everywhere, and therefore you are the knower of all. Purport. As stated in Brahma Samhita, Eko pi asho rachasitum jagadanda kotim yas chaktirasti jagadanda chayata yadanta adantarasto paramana chayantarastam govindam adipurusham tamam jami. Quote, I worship this personality of Godhead, Govinda, who by one of his plenary portions enters the existence of every universe and every atomic particle and thus manifests his infinite energy unlimitedly throughout the material creation, end quote. Brahma Samhita 5:35. Ananda chinmayarasa pratitabitabi tabir yaeva nija rupataya kalabi goloka eva nirasat nivasati akilat mabuta govinda madipurusham damam jami. I worship Govinda, the primeval lord, who resides in his own realm, Goloka, with Radha, who resembles his own spiritual figure and who embodies the ecstatic potency, Haladini. Their companions are her confidants, who embody extensions of her bodily form and who are imbued and permeated with ever-blissful spiritual rasa, end quote. Brahma Samhita 537. Although Govinda is always present in his abode, Goloka Eva Nivasati, he is simultaneously present everywhere. Nothing is unknown to him, and nothing can be hidden from him. The example given here compares the Lord to the air, which is within the vast sky and within everybody, but is still different from everything. Text 12. My Lord, I have seen all kinds of incarnations you have exhibited by your transcendental qualities, and now that you have appeared as a beautiful young woman, I wish to see that form of your lordship. Purport. When Lord Shiva approached Lord Vishnu inquired about the purpose for Lord Shiva's coming there. Now Lord Shiva discloses his desire. He wanted to see the recent incarnation of Mohini Murti, which Lord Vishnu had assumed to distribute the nectar generated from the churning of the ocean of milk. Text 13. My Lord, we have come here desiring to see that form of your lordship, which you showed to the demons to captivate them completely, and in this way enable the demigods to drink nectar. I am very eager to see that form. Texts 14. Shukadev Goswami said, when Lord Vishnu was thus requested by Lord Shiva, who carries a trident in his hand, he smiled with gravity and replied to Lord Shiva as follows. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, is known as Yogeshwar, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna. Mystic yogis want to acquire some power by practicing the yoga system, but Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is known as the Supreme Lord of all mystic power. Lord Shiva wanted to see the Mohini Murti, which was captivating the entire world, and Lord Vishnu was gravely thinking of how to captivate Lord Shiva also. Therefore, the word Bhava Grambiram is used here. The illusory material energy is represented by Durga Devi, who is the wife of Garisha, or Lord Shiva. Durga Devi could not captivate Lord Shiva's mind, but now that Lord Shiva wanted to see Lord Vishnu's feminine form, Lord Vishnu, by his mystic power, could assume a form that would captivate even Lord Shiva. Therefore, Lord Vishnu was grave and at the same time was smiling. Text 15. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, when the demons took away the jug of nectar, I assumed the form of a beautiful woman to bewilder them by directly cheating them and thus to act in the interest of the demigods. Purport. When the Supreme Personality of Godhead assumed the form of a beautiful woman, Mohini Murti, the demons were certainly captivated, but the demigods present were not. In other words, those who maintain a demonic mentality are bewildered by the beauty of a woman, but those who are advanced in Krishna consciousness, or even those on the platform of goodness, are not bewildered. The Supreme Personality of Godhead knew that because Lord Shiva is not an ordinary person, he cannot be bewildered even by the most beautiful woman. Cupid himself tried to invoke Lord Shiva's lusty desires in the presence of Parvati, but Lord Shiva was never agitated. Rather, the blazing fire from Lord Shiva's eyes turned Cupid to ashes. Therefore, Lord Vishnu had to think twice about what kind of beautiful form would bewilder even Lord Shiva. Consequently, he was smiling gravely, as stated in the previous verse. Prasya Bhava Grambiram. A beautiful woman generally cannot induce Lord Shiva to become lusty, but Lord Vishnu was considering whether there was any form of a woman who could enchant him. Text 16. O best of the demigods, I shall now show you my form that is very much appreciated by those who are lusty. Since you want to see that form, I shall reveal it in your presence. Purport. Lord Shiva's desiring to see Lord Vishnu reveal the most attractive and beautiful form of a woman was certainly a joking affair. Lord Shiva knew that he could not be agitated by any so-called beautiful woman. Quote, the Daityas may have been bewildered, end quote, he thought. Quote, but since even the demigods could not be agitated, what to speak of me, who am the best of all the demigods, end quote. However, because Lord Shiva wanted to see Lord Vishnu's form as a woman, Lord Vishnu decided to impersonate a woman and show him a form that would immediately put him into an ocean of lusty desires. In effect, therefore, Lord Vishnu told Lord Shiva, quote, I will show you my form as a woman, and if you become agitated by lusty desires, do not blame me, end quote. The attractive features of a woman are appreciated by those who are affected by lusty desires, but those who are above such desires, who are on the platform of Krishna consciousness, are very difficult to bewilder. Nonetheless, by the supreme desire of the personality of Godhead, everything can be done. This was to be a test of whether Lord Shiva could remain unagitated. Text 17. Sugadeva Goswami continued, after speaking in this way, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, immediately disappeared, and Lord Shiva remained there with Uma, looking for him around, all around with moving eyes. Text 18. Thereafter, in a nice forest nearby, full of trees with reddish pink leaves and varieties of flowers, Lord Shiva saw a beautiful woman playing with a ball. Her hips were covered with a shining sari and ornamented with a belt. Text 19. Because the ball was falling down and bouncing up, as she played with it, her breasts trembled, and because of the weight of those breasts and her heavy flower garlands, her waist appeared to be all but breaking at every step, as her two soft feet, which were reddish like coral, moved here and there. Text 20. The woman's face was decorated by broad, beautiful, restless eyes, which moved as the ball bounced here and there from her hand. The two brilliant earrings on her ears decorated her shining cheeks like bluish reflections, and the hair scattered on her face made her even more beautiful to see. Text 21. As she played with the ball, the sari covering her body became loose, and her hair scattered. She tried to bind her hair with her beautiful left hand, and at the same time she played with the ball by striking it with her right hand. This was so attractive that the Supreme Lord, by his internal potency in this way, captivated everyone. Purport. In Bhagavad Gita 7.14, it is said, Daivahi shaguna mayi mama maya daratya. The external potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is extremely strong. Indeed, everyone is captivated by her activities. Lord Shambhu, Shiva, was not to be captivated by the external potency, but because Lord Vishnu wanted to captivate him also, he exhibited his internal potency to act the way that his external potency acts to captivate ordinary living entities. Lord Vishnu can captivate anyone, even such a strong personality as Lord Shambhu. Text 22. While Lord Shiva observed the beautiful woman playing with the ball, she sometimes glanced at him and slightly smiled in bashfulness. As he looked at the beautiful woman and she watched him, he forgot both himself and Uma, his most beautiful wife, as well as his associates nearby. Purport. The material bondage of this world is that a beautiful woman can captivate a handsome man and that a handsome man can captivate a beautiful woman. Such are the affairs that began when Lord Shiva observed the beautiful girl playing with the ball. In such activities, the influence of Cupid is very prominent. As both parties move their eyebrows and glance at one another, their lusty desires increase more and more. Such reciprocations of lusty desire took place between Lord Shiva and the beautiful woman, even though Uma and Lord Shiva's associates were by Lord Shiva's side. Such is the attraction between man and woman in the material world. Lord Shiva is supposed to be above all this attraction, but because he was victimized by the captivating power of Lord Vishnu, Rishabhdev thus explains the nature of lusty attraction. Pumsham Shriya Mituni Bhava Mitam Teor Mita Hiriyanta Granti Ahu Atagriha Kshetra Sutapta Advatar Janasya Mohayam Ahamameti. Quote, the attraction between male and female is the basic principle of material existence. On the basis of this misconception, which ties together the hearts of the male and female, one becomes attracted to his body, home, property, children, relatives, and wealth. In this way, one increases life's illusions and thinks in terms of I and mine, end quote. Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.8. When a man and woman exchange feelings of lust, both of them are victimized, and thus they are bound to this material world in various ways. Text 23. When the ball leapt from her hand and fell at a distance, the woman began to follow it. But as Lord Shiva observed these activities, a breeze suddenly blew away the fine dress and belt that covered her. Text 24. Thus, Lord Shiva saw the woman, every part of whose body was beautifully formed, and the beautiful woman also looked at him. Therefore, thinking that she was attracted to him, Lord Shiva became very much attracted to her. Report. Lord Shiva was observing every part of the woman's body, and she was also glancing at him with restless eyes. Thus, Lord Shiva thought that she was attracted to him, and now he wanted to touch her. Text 25. Lord Shiva, his good sense taken away by the woman because of lusty desires to enjoy with her, became so mad for her that even in the presence of Bhavani, he did not hesitate to approach her. Text 26. The beautiful woman was already naked, and when she saw Lord Shiva coming toward her, she became extremely bashful. Thus, she kept smiling, but she hid herself among the trees and did not stand in one place. Text 27. His senses being agitated, Lord Shiva, victimized by lusty desires, began to follow her, just as a lusty elephant follows a she-elephant. Text 28. After following her with great speed, Lord Shiva caught her by the braid of her hair and dragged her near him, although she was unwilling, he embraced her with his arms. Text 29 and 30. Being embraced by Lord Shiva like a female elephant embraced by a male, the woman whose hair was scattered swirled like a snake. O King, this woman who had large, high hips was a woman of Yogamaya presented by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. She released herself somehow or other from the fond embrace of Lord Shiva's arms and ran away. Text 31. As if harassed by an enemy in the form of lusty desires, Lord Shiva followed the path of Lord Vishnu, who acts very wonderfully and who had taken the form of Mohini. Purport. Lord Shiva cannot be victimized by Maya. Therefore, it is to be understood that Lord Shiva was thus being harassed by Lord Shiva of Vishnu's internal potency. Lord Vishnu can perform many wonderful activities through his various potencies. Parashya Shakti Vividai Vishiti Svabhavika Janabhya Balakriya Cha, Sveta Svatara Upanishad 6.8. The Supreme Lord has various potencies by which he can act very efficiently. He can do anything expertly, and he doesn't need to contemplate. Since Lord Shiva was being harassed by the woman, it is to be understood that this was being done not by a woman, but by Lord Vishnu himself. Text 32. Just as a maddened bull elephant follows a female elephant who is able to conceive pregnancy, Lord Shiva followed the beautiful woman and discharged semen, even though his discharge of semen never goes in vain. Text 33. O King, wheresoever on the surface of the globe fell the semen of the great personality Lord Shiva, mines of gold and silver later appeared. Purport. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur comments that those who seek gold and silver can worship Lord Shiva for material opulences. Lord Shiva lives under a bail tree and does not even construct a house in which to dwell, but although he is apparently poverty-stricken, his devotees are sometimes opulently endowed with large quantities of gold and silver. Prickett Maharaj later asks about this, and Shukadeva Goswami replies, Text 34. Following Mohini, Lord Shiva went everywhere, near the shores of the rivers and lakes, near the mountains, near the forests, near the gardens, and wherever there lived great sages. Purport. Srila Vishnachagarai Thakur remarks that Mohini Murti dragged Lord Shiva to so many places, especially to where the great sages lived, to instruct the sages that their Lord Shiva had become mad for a beautiful woman. Thus, although they were all great sages and saintly persons, they should not think themselves free, but should remain extremely cautious about beautiful women. No one should think himself liberated in the presence of a beautiful woman. The Shastras enjoin, Matasvara Swasra Duhitrava Naiviki Atashanu Bhavat Balavan Indriagramo Vidvamsam Apikarshati. Quote, one should not stay in a solitary place with a woman, even if she be his mother, sister, or daughter, for the senses are so uncontrollably powerful that in the presence of a woman, one may become agitated even if he is very learned and advanced. End quote. Srimad Bhagavatam 9.19.17. Text 35. O Maharaj Prickett, O best of kings, when Lord Shiva had fully discharged semen, he could see how he himself had been victimized by the illusion created by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thus, he restrained himself from any further maya. Purport. Once one is agitated by lusty desires upon seeing a woman, those desires increase more and more, but when semen is discharged in the act of sex, the lusty desires diminish. The same principle acted upon Lord Shiva. He was allured by the beautiful woman Mohini Murti, but when his semen had been fully discharged, he came to his senses and realized how he had been victimized as soon as he saw the woman in the forest. If one is trained to protect his semen by observing celibacy, naturally he is not attracted by the beauty of a woman. If one can remain a brahmachari, he saves himself so much trouble in material existence. Material existence means enjoying the pleasure of sexual intercourse. Yan maitunadi grihamedi sukham. If one is educated about sex life and trained to protect his semen, he is saved from the danger of material existence. Text 36. Thus, Lord Shiva could understand his position and that of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has unlimited potencies. Having reached this understanding, he was not at all surprised by the wonderful way Lord Vishnu had acted upon him. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is known as all-powerful because no one can excel him in any activity. In Bhagavad Gita 7.7, the Lord says, Mata paratanam nanyat kinshchidastadananjaya. Quote, O conqueror of wealth, there is no truth superior to me. End quote. No one can equal the Lord or be greater than him, for he is the master of everyone. As stated in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adi 5.142, Ekale Ishvara Krishna Arashabha Britya. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is the only master of everyone, including even Lord Shiva, what to speak of others. Lord Shiva was already aware of the supreme power of Lord Vishnu, but when he was actually put into bewilderment, he felt proud to have such an exalted master. Text 37. Seeing Lord Shiva unagitated and unashamed, Lord Vishnu, Madhusudana, was very pleased. Thus he resumed his original form and spoke as follows. Purport. Although Lord Shiva was aghast at the potency of Lord Vishnu, he did not feel ashamed. Rather, he was proud to be defeated by Lord Vishnu. Nothing is hidden from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, for he is in everyone's heart. Indeed, the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 15.15, Sarvasya chaham hridi sanavisto matismiti gyanam apohanam cha. Quote, I am seated in everyone's heart, and from me come remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness. End quote. Whatever happened had taken place under the direction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and therefore there was no cause to be sorry or ashamed. Although Lord Shiva is never defeated by anyone, when defeated by Lord Vishnu, he felt proud that he had such an exalted and powerful master. Text 38. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, O best of the demigods, although you have been amply harassed because of my potency in assuming the form of a woman, you are established in your position. Therefore, may all good fortune be upon you. Purport. Since Lord Shiva is the best of the demigods, he is the best of all devotees. Vaishnavam yata Shambhu, his exemplary character, was therefore praised by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who gave his benediction by saying, quote, may all good fortune be upon you, end quote. When a devotee becomes a little proud, the Supreme Lord sometimes exhibits his supreme power to dissipate the devotee's misunderstanding. After being amply harassed by Lord Vishnu's potency, Lord Shiva resumed his normal, unagitated condition. This is the position of a devotee. A devotee should not be agitated under any circumstances, even in the worst reverses, as confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 6.22, Yasmin stito na dukena gurunapi vachalyate. Because of his full faith in the Supreme Personality of Godhead, a devotee is never agitated, even in the greatest trials. This pridelessness is possible only for first-class devotees, of whom Lord Shambhu is one. Text 39. My dear Lord Shambhu, who in this material world but you can surpass my illusory energy? People are generally attached to sense enjoyment and conquered by its influence. Indeed, the influence of material nature is very difficult for them to surmount. Purport. Of the three chief demigods, Brahma, Vishnu, and Maheshwar, all but Vishnu are under the influence of Maya. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, they are described as Mayi, which means under Maya's influence. But even though Lord Shiva associates with Maya, he is not influenced. But the living entities are affected by Maya, but although Lord Shiva apparently associates with Maya, he is not affected. In other words, all living entities within this material world, except for Lord Shiva, are swayed by Maya. Lord Shiva is therefore neither Vishnu Tattva nor Jiva Tattva. He is between the two. Text 40. The material external energy Maya, who cooperates with me in creation and who is manifested in the three modes of nature, will not be able to bewilder you any longer. Purport. When Lord Shiva was present, his wife, Durga, was also there. Durga works in cooperation with the Supreme Personality of Godhead in creating the cosmic manifestation. The Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 9.10, Maya Dakshena Prakriti Suyate Sacharacharam, quote, the material energy Prakriti works under my direction, O son of Kunti, and is producing all moving and unmoving beings, end quote. Prakriti is Durga. Shristi Stiti Pralaya Sadhana Shaktireka Chayeva Yasya Bhuvani Bibhati Durga. The entire cosmos is created by Durga in cooperation with Lord Vishnu in the form of Kala, time. Sa Iksata Lokanu Shrija Sa Imal Lokan Ashrijata. This is the version of the Vedas, Aitareya Upanishad 1.1.1 and 2. Maya happens to be the wife of Lord Shiva, and thus Lord Shiva is in association with Maya, but Lord Vishnu here assures Lord Shiva that this Maya will no longer be able to captivate him. Text 41. Shukadeva Goswami said, O King, having thus been praised by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who bears the mark of Shivat on his chest, Lord Shiva circumambulated him. Then, after taking permission from him, Lord Shiva returned to his abode, Kailash, along with his associates. Purport. Srila Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur remarks that when Lord Shiva was offering obeisances unto Lord Vishnu arose and embraced him. Therefore, the word Shivatsan Kena is used here. The mark of Shivatsa adorns the chest of Lord Vishnu, and therefore when Lord Vishnu embraced Lord Shiva while being circumambulated, the Shivatsa mark touched Lord Shiva's bosom. Text 42. O descendant of Maharaj Bharat, Lord Shiva in jubilation then addressed his wife Bhavani, who is accepted by all authorities as the potency of Lord Vishnu. Text 43. Lord Shiva said, O goddess, You have now seen the illusory energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the unborn master of everyone. Although I am one of the principal expansions of his lordship, even I was illusioned by his energy. What then is to be said of others who are fully dependent on Maya? Text 44. When I finished performing mystic yoga for 1,000 years, you asked me upon whom I was meditating. Now, here is that Supreme Person to whom time has no entrance and who the Vedas cannot understand. Purport. Eternal time enters anywhere and everywhere, but it cannot enter the kingdom of God, nor can the Vedas understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is an indication of the Lord's being omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. Text 45. Shukadev Goswami said, my dear King, the person who bore the great mountain on his back for the churning of the ocean of milk is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, known as Sarangandhanva. I have now described to you his prowess. Text 46. The endeavor of one who constantly hears or describes this narration of the churning of the ocean of milk will never be fruitless. Indeed, chanting the glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the only means to annihilate all sufferings in this material world. Text 47. Assuming the form of a young woman and thus bewildering the demons, the Supreme Personality of Godhead distributed to his devotees, the demigods, the nectar produced from the churning of the ocean of milk. Unto that Supreme Personality of Godhead, who always fulfills the desires of his devotees, I offer my respectful obeisances. Purport. The instructions of this narration concerning the churning of the milk ocean is clearly manifested by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Although he is equal to everyone, because of natural affection, he favors his devotees. The Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 9:21, Samaham sarvabhuteshu name dvesho stinapriya ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya mayi te tishu chapyaham. Quote, I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all. But whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him. End quote. This partiality of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is natural. A person cares for his children, not because of partiality, but in a reciprocation of love. The children depend on the father's affection, and the father affectionately maintains the children. Similarly, because devotees do not know anything but the lotus feet of the Lord is always prepared to give protection to his devotees and fulfill their desires. He therefore says, Kuntiya pratijanihi namai bhaktiya pranashiti. Quote, O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee never perishes. End quote. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta purports of the 8th canto, 12th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled, The Mohini Murti Incarnation Bewilders Lord Shiva.